हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाय, दिस इज प्रोफेसर गजानन पटले, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, आभा गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, नागपुर। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस 1 week ऑनलाइन सर्टिफिकेशन प्रोग्राम ऑन एडवांस जावा, विच इज शेड्यूल्ड फ्रॉम 13 अप्रैल टू 18 अप्रैल 2020। आफ्टर द वंडरफुल welcome note by Mr. Bhushan, the lead system engineer, Melbourne, Australia. Now, we are moving towards the day one session. In this session, I am going to explain you how to set up Java environment part, which is most important before beginning to execute any Java program on any operating system. So in this session, we are installing the Java setup on Windows platform. Okay, so we are going to cover some of the concept like installation of JDK version 8, then setup of Java path and basic concept of Java, and next one, object oriented programming concept. So in this video lecture, I am going to cover first two, that is the installation of JDK 8 and setup of Java path. Okay, so it might have some question in your mind, why it's necessary or why it is required to set up this Java path. Okay, so why it is required? So in the Java development kit, Java development kit, the JDK is a software development environment which is used for developing a Java application as well as applet. It includes Java runtime environment, we call it as a JRE, and an interpreter or a loader, that is Java, as well as a compiler Java C and the archiver JAR, and documentation generator Java doc, and other tools needed in a Java development. Okay, to execute Java console based program on Windows okay environment, we have to use Java and Java C command. Since Java and Java C commands are unknown for the Windows, till we do not specify explicitly where those executable code reside. Okay, so without setting up these two paths for the Java and the Java C, okay, Windows will not recognize these two tools of a Java, okay, while compiling and execution of a Java code. Otherwise, it will give an error, that is, these two code are not an internal or external commands. Okay, so this is the reason while setting the Java path, we specify path of a bin. So okay friends, so let's start with the installation of JDK 8. So for this, we have to download the JDK 8. Okay, so just search on the Google, just download JDK. Okay, you will get a different link. So this is the official website of a Java, that is www.oracle.com. Okay, just click it. So now you have seen the different versions of a Java. So latest version is Java SE14. Okay, and I am going to install Java 8 on my this system. Okay, so here we have a link, that is a JDK download. Okay, so now you have seen here there are different types of versions are available according to the operating system, for the Linux, for the Mac OS, for Windows operating system. So I am using the Windows system. So for the Windows system, you have to know whether you are using Windows 64 or Windows 32 bits. Okay, so you need to download according to that, either 64 or 32 bit. Okay, So this is the Windows 14. If you require the less version like 13, 10, 11, 8 or any other, so you have to search accordingly and download it. I'm not going to download this setup because I have already downloaded this setup. Okay, so now start with the installation. Just double click on the JDK application. Okay, then click on is. Okay, so in this process you are going to install the two tools, that is a JDK and JRE. So after successfully installation of this JDK application, you will find in your drive that C drive, okay, where the operating system is installed. Okay, go to C drive, then program files, then you will see one folder is created, Java. Just open it. Okay, now you have seen two folder are created, JDK and JRE. Okay, so you need to provide this path to the system variable. So how to provide the path? Okay, so first we have to copy the path of a JDK, okay, and then JRE. Okay, to set up the Java path, we have to first go to the start, then computer, right click on computer, that is go to the properties. Now you have seen one option there, advanced system setting, or you can do one thing, just search it, like type, just type, you have to type it, advanced system. Okay. Advanced system setting. Okay, here this is the another way. Okay, this is the one way and this is the another way to know the environment variable. Okay, just go to the advanced system setting. Okay, then this is the system properties. You will get the one option, that is the set up the environmental variable. Okay, then you have to set up the two variables, that's a path and a class path. Okay, in a system variable. So first of all, you need to find whether this two path is already available in this console or not. Okay, so just check it here. So one variable is already in the system variable, so you have need to edit it first. Just click on the edit button. Remember that whatever the existing path is available, okay, you need to, you know, okay, don't delete it. Okay, then how to set up the path? Just first of all, you need to provide the semicolon here. Okay, then go back to the JDK, then bin. Okay, so this bin path, you have to copy it and paste into the path variable. Okay, I am going to copy it. First of all, copy, then paste here, then semicolon, then go back to the Java JRE, then bin folder, again copy, okay, then paste in the system variable, that is a path variable, paste it, then save. So now we have successfully set up the path variable. Okay, now we have to search for the class path variable, whether the class path variable is available or not. If it is not available, you have to create it. Okay, so give the name class path, and now what is the variable value? Variable value means the path of a JDK and JRE. Okay, so same procedure you have to follow it for JDK, bin, then copy, okay, paste it here, semicolon, then Java JRE, bin, copy it, and then paste. Okay, remember here at the last you have to put up the semicolon and then dot. Okay, so there is no need to put up the dot in a path variable, but it is necessary to provide the dot variable in a class path variable. Okay, then click on OK. okay, and then okay. So this is done with the installation and the ClassPass variable.